As part of Care 11's year-long commitment to bring you stories from Lucy Laney Elementary in North Minneapolis, we are diving into the joys and challenges the school faces each and every day.
This next issue is complicated, a topic that's been a tough sell in some schools. We're talking about dialect, the way students speak, why the school believes, above all, a language of acceptance is a link to their success.
A dialect is like...
Isn't it like dialogue?
To dissect dialect.
Is it about, like, how you speak?
A spoken variety of language. We begin by hearing voices rich with innocence.
African American
Vernacular English.
It's a good thing that I read books, but I've never come across that word.
African American Vernacular English, or AAVE, refers to the distinctive dialect historically spoken by African Americans, a style formerly known as Ebonics.
I would imagine that there may be some comments that are like, yeah, teach those kids how to speak English.
It's considered broken English, Ebonics, slang. And why is that?
Educators at Lucy Laney Elementary in North Minneapolis know it's controversial, but invite you to listen to their own linguistic revolution.
That will not make them feel like foreigners in a foreign land from the second they walk into the doors.
Honoring the home dialect of students at a school where the majority of kids are African American.
You need to be connected to something.
In fourth grade science.
Were you able to control the magnet?
Mr. Davis knows how two worlds connect, seeing himself in his students. Once an inner city Milwaukee kid who never dreamed he could become a teacher.
English, when I got to high school, was like, it was always a rough patch for me. I remember getting corrected on so many times where when I used to say finna, I'm finna go do this. They'd be like, wait, what? What? You finna do what? And they'd be like, you're about to go over here. What is the source of energy that we use?
Only during college did Mr. Davis master what it means to code switch.
Ms. Bryant.
Electric current.
Electric current is correct.
For him, alternating between the dialect he knew and the dominant white dialect.
Available.
Yeah. And it might look different, it might sound different than the way white Americans speak, but that's okay.
Class?
Yes, yes.
We know that dinosaurs lived on Earth
65 million years ago.
When you come into Lucy Laney, when you come into Mr. Davis' classroom, I accept you for everything that you bring.
We're gonna be looking in our book.
And in first grade, Miss Ellison realized her own role in rewriting a narrative.
And stared out at the snow.
After reading her students a book in black vernacular.
And I'm reading these books with black vernacular, and I'm just feeling like I'm clumsy and stumbling and really uncomfortable with the way that I feel like I'm sounding as I'm reading this.
The
sunny day. Really what I'm asking them to do every day when they come into my room and have to read books in standard English is to really put themselves in that same place of discomfort that I felt, and that place of awkwardness and clumsiness, and is really a shame.
If her students couldn't see themselves in a story, how do they fit into a system? Questions considered by one University of Minnesota professor.
This is a complex problem with no easy solution.
Dr. Ben Munson teaches speech, language, and hearing science.
The kids who don't spontaneously learn to code switch are the ones that are going to experience the most difficulty at school.
Futures determined by what he believes is a past rooted in racism, all the way to the dialect's origins in West Africa.
I mean, to think that this was a language that was born when people were enslaved and treated like animals and brought over to the U.S. to essentially build this country's economic base that white Americans disproportionately benefit from to this day.
So do you think that more schools should be attempting to have this vulnerable conversation?
I think so, for sure.
And so it's important to me as a school community that we address that.
Lucy Laney principal Mari Frieslaben offers an example with the use of the word
X. I would be like, Dad, can I ask you a question?
We had a conversation about that the other day, like, you're going to ax me to death with an axe?
You actually have to write it the academic English appropriate way, which is asked. And so I'm going to help you translate that.
In the same way, teachers would help any student learning English for the first time.
Is that word an adjective?
S-A.
This is an important conversation for all educators. Language is how children communicate the mastery of their concepts. It shouldn't be how they communicate their mastery. It should be whether they've mastered or not.
The beauty of AAVE. Have you ever heard somebody say that before?
Keith Mays, professor of African American Studies at the U, proposes retraining teachers, developing curriculum to better understand how the dialect is steeped across cultures.
White people use Black vernacular English all the time. It becomes popular slang, or they may like rap music. There's AAVE all around us.
Your job is to come up with...
For most Lucy Laney students, the dialect long under scrutiny is still a language of wonder. How they learned their first words, learned to love. A belief now at the core of each class, where teachers have come to understand dismissing a child's words only diminishes their identity.
I refuse to be living in an educational reality that is going to, as the children walk in the door, go ignorant, stupid, uneducated. I will not do that. As they come in this door, they are going to be validated from their head to their toes.
So certainly a journey for me as a reporter. I learned a lot. Mr. Davis told me about the word finna, and I said, what? And he had to educate me on what finna is. And, you know, I think, though, looking a little deeper, we all sort of have learned to code switch in our own lives. We hopscotch between different styles of talking with our friends, and essentially, again, that's what they're trying to help kids do. This is what you have to read in your book. This is how you're going to succeed in the world. You have to learn this to succeed in the world for a job interview, but it is okay that you say X at home with your family or whenever you want to.
Yeah, she brings up that beautiful point, because from the beginning of your journey with Lucy Laney, with these staff and students, tantamount, central to the mission, is you are who you are from your toes to the top.
Mm-hmm.
Don't dismiss a person's culture or how they speak with their aunts and uncles and pastors and preachers and police officers and firemen in their community. That's ridiculous. We don't ask anyone else to do that.
True.
And the Black vernacular is not the only dialect. That, you know, this is something that we've isolated here, but you talk about how people speak in the South or maybe how the East Coast. And it's so interesting. Mm-hmm. We don't think of the same things and how we view those dialects, right? Some people do.
Right. We see President George W. Bush say he's fixing to go clear some brush. That's charming.
Right.
What's the difference? It's a great point. I thought it was a wonderful piece of journalism, really. It gave all the viewers an incredible window, and it's something that's perhaps just down the street.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't think about it because it maybe isn't your culture, right?
I didn't.
That was wonderful. Mm-hmm. My question to you is, how are the kids reacting to this? They seemed playful and innocent about it, which I guess I would suspect. How did the kids react to this, like, really complex topic?
It took a little while to peel back the layers and help them understand, you know, what the story was about, because they're not conscious that their school is intentionally doing this. And I had some kids say, I don't think Black and white people speak any differently. Some kids had no awareness, but some kids, like the ones you saw there that said acts, that they get it. So that they're tuning into this a little bit when, you know, as they grow older with their peers. But, you know, again, the innocence, they're not aware.
And how important it is, especially, I've heard this talked about by school administrators and school leaders and educational leaders, to have teachers of color in the classroom. There's just not enough teachers of color right now to have that reinforcement. You know, Mr. Davis's tale of how he became a teacher is really cool.
And for him to say, I feel comfortable being myself in front of this classroom when I never thought I could be. And I believe that he has a stronger connection with those students. They see themselves in him, or they could be him.
Yeah.
And he's reaching them in a different way than a white teacher.
Very cool. Incredible, as always. Thank you, Lindsay, for the latest chapter from Lucy Laney. We'll be right back.